Drafting getting started. Before getting into the detailed instructions for using drafting, the following tutorial aims at giving you a feel of what you can do with the product. It provides step-by-step scenarios showing you how to use basic capabilities and key functionalities. First, you'll learn how to define a drawing sheet for use in the subsequent scenarios. Then, the part drawing section explains how to generate various types of views from a part, while the assembly drawing section shows how to generate views from an assembly and illustrates other generative functionalities. Simply follow the instructions as you go along. Note that you can perform each section of this tutorial independently, depending on your specific drawing needs. Defining the drawing sheet. This task shows you how to define the drawing sheet that will be used for creating the views described in the next tasks. Select File, New, or click New in the standard toolbar. The new dialog box is displayed. Select Drawing from the list of types and click OK. The new drawing dialog box is displayed. Select the ISO standard and the A0 ISO format. Click OK. In the drafting workbench, a grid is set by default. For the purpose of this tutorial, you will not use the grid. To hide it, activate Sketch a Grid in the Visualization toolbar. The drawing sheet appears as shown. From now on, you'll work on this sheet. You can now either learn how to create part drawings or assembly drawings. Note that you can define a new additional sheet at any time. Part drawing. In this first section of the Getting Started tutorial, you'll learn how to generate various types of views from a part on the drawing sheet you previously defined. We will go through listed tasks in this section. Opening a part. This task will show you how to open the 3D part from which you will create views in the drafting workbench. Select File, Open, or click Open in the standard toolbar. The File Selection dialog box appears. Select the part to be opened. GenDrafting underscore part cat part document. You can find the file link in the description. Click Open. If a message appears informing you that it is read only, simply close it. The part will remain displayed in the window, whatever views you create from it. Creating a front view. This task will show you how to create a front view on the sheet you defined, from the 3D part you opened. At this step, it will be more convenient if you tile the drawing and the part windows horizontally. To do this, click Window. Tile horizontally from the menu bar. In the drafting workbench, the view name, scaling factor and view frame are set by default in views. Throughout this section of the Getting Started, we decided not to display view names and scaling factors. To deactivate them, go to Tools, Options, Mechanical Design, Drafting. Click on the Layout tab and clear the View Name and Scaling Factor checkboxes. You can also specify what geometrical and dress-up elements should be generated on views, such as axes, centerlines, fillets, 3D points, etc. For this, click on the View tab and choose your options in Geometry Generation, Dress-up. For example, select the Generate Centerlines checkbox, and clear the Generate Fillet checkbox. If you do not want to have the specification tree displayed, press the F3 key. Click the drawing window to activate it. Click Front View in the Views toolbar. Now, in the Part window, select the desired planar surface of the 3D part. On the sheet, a blue knob appears, as well as a green frame containing a preview of the view to be created. The knob lets you define the location and orientation of the view to be created using the blue manipulators, top, bottom, left, right, or rotated according to a given snapping, or according to a specified rotation angle. Click on the drawing sheet or at the center of the blue knob to generate the view. A progress bar appears temporarily, showing the view creation progress. The front view is created. Creating a projection view. This task will show you how to create projection views on the sheet. Click Projection View in the Views toolbar. A preview of the view to be created appears. By default, the projection view is aligned to the front view. As you move the cursor, the preview keeps appearing, as long as you keep the cursor positioned at a possible projection view location, at the left, right, top or bottom of the red frame. Define the projection view position, for example the right view position, using the cursor. Note that the left view shown here was created and therefore positioned according to ISO standards and the first angle projection method. Click to generate the view. A progress bar appears while the view is being created. Click Projection View once again. Use the cursor to define the projection view position, for example the bottom view position, and click to generate the view. Once again, a progress bar appears during the view creation process. The view's result has shown. Creating a section view. This task will show you how to create a section view using the front view you previously generated. Section views make drawings more readable by replacing the hidden elements of parts, including holes, with filled areas. To perform this scenario, it is recommended that you tile the drawing and the part windows horizontally. In the drawing window, click Offset Section View in the Views toolbar. Select the holes and points to define the cutting profile on the view. Smart Pick assists you when creating the profile. Note that selecting a circular edge, a linear edge, an axis line or a center line, for example, a hole, makes the view callout associative by default to the corresponding 3D feature. If you select a circle, the callout will go through the circle center. If you select an edge, the callout will be parallel to the selected edge. If you are not satisfied with the profile you create, you can, at any time, use the undo or redo icons. As you select the second point, the section plane appears and moves dynamically on the 3D part while you define the profile on the drawing. This section plane will automatically disappear when you double-click to end the callout definition. Double-click to end the cutting profile creation. A preview is displayed. Define the section view position using the cursor. Positioning the view also defines the section view direction, as if it were a left or a right projection view. The direction of the callout blue arrows changes as you change the cursor position. Using the cursor, you can then position the section view in order to align it or to not align it to the front view. Click to generate the view. A progress bar appears while the view is being created. Creating a detail view. This task will show you how to create a detail view from the front view you previously generated. Click Detail View in the Views toolbar. Click where you want to position the callout center. Drag the cursor to define the callout radius, and click when you are satisfied. A dashed blue circle appears at the position of the cursor. Move this circle to where you want to position the detail view, and click to generate the view. A progress bar appears while the view is being created. If you are not satisfied with the position of the detail view, you can drag and drop it to a new position. The scale is by default twice that of the active view. You can modify this scale. To do so, right-click the Detail view, select Properties and then click the View tab. Enter 4:1 in the Scale field and click OK. For the purpose of this exercise, you'll now add a dimension to the Detail view. To do so, click Dimension in the Dimensioning toolbar. Click two elements in the view, as shown. The dimension is created. Move your cursor to where you want to position the dimension, and click to generate the dimension. If you are not satisfied with the position of the dimension, you can drag and drop it to a new position. Creating a section cut. This task will show you how to create a section cut from the detail view you just created. The scale of the section cut will depend on the scale of the view this section cut is generated from. In this case, the section cut is generated from a detail view with a scale 4, so the section cut scale will also be 4. Right-click the detail view and select Activate View. Click Aligned Section Cut in the Views toolbar. Select a point, hole edge, and, again point to define the cutting profile. Double-click to end the cutting profile creation. A preview of the view to be created appears. Positioning the section cut either to the right or to the left defines the section cut direction, as if it were a projection view. Click to generate the section cut. A progress bar appears while the view is being created. Once the section cut has been generated, you can modify its position relatively to the detail view. Right-click the section cut and select View Positioning. Position independently of reference view from the contextual menu. To add a diameter dimension to the section cut, click Dimension and click one edge only. If diameter doesn't appear automatically, you can select diameter from the same menu. You have reached the end of the first section of this tutorial. Now that you have learned about part drawings, you can go to the second section of this tutorial and learn about assembly drawings.